What is this magical black chip that charges your phone, opens your car, makes your coffee in the morning, and even keeps your beer chilled? This is, of course, a microcontroller unit, or MCU. Those chips power billions of devices all over the world, and some of them are so tiny they are smaller than the size of a coin. A microcontroller unit is a small computer on a single integrated circuit that contains a processor core, memory, and programmable input-output peripherals. They are designed for embedded systems and are commonly used in control systems, industrial automation, consumer electronics, and other applications that require a compact, low-power device to perform a specific task. It is very similar to a motherboard of your computer, but in a smaller form factor. The brain of this computer is, of course, the central processing unit, or the CPU. It is the primary component that performs arithmetic and logical operations and manages the flow of data through the computer. The CPU is connected to memory, storage, and other components through a bus, and it communicates with them to perform tasks and execute instructions such as add, sum, move, and others. Those instructions are low-level machine code and are specific to a particular CPU architecture. They are stored in non-volatile memory, which means that your data will be safe if a power outage occurs. But it is also the slowest type of memory, so when your computer boots up, the firmware loads the specific instructions from the storage to the RAM and to the cache. Those two, as well as the virtual memory and the register memory, are much faster, but volatile. Brain and memory just by themselves are useless unless you are a mad scientist stuck in a cucumber. It is like a phone without a service or a pen without an ink. In other words, the MCU needs peripherals to expand its capabilities, and that's why MCUs come with built-in ones. The basic ones are timers that can show you the real-time or generate PWM signals, data converters that convert analog to digital or digital to analog signals, amplifier peripherals that strengthen or condition the signal, and communication peripherals that receive and send data to other modules and sensors via communication protocols. Of course, you can add other peripherals like joysticks, gamepads, fingerprint scanners, and other sensors to provide additional data or control the environment or other devices. All of those features make the MCU powerful and very popular. It is compact, has low power consumption, it's cost-effective, flexible, and easy to program. Moreover, there is a huge open source community where you can gather new ideas and easily debug your problem. The easiest way to start your project is to have one of those plug-and-play boards from Arduino or Microchip or Texas Instruments, which you can find on our website TMEU. But should you use a microcontroller unit for every application? We will check it in another video.